Hello everyone, I'm Dylan. Welcome back. Today we're playing Starfield again. I'm going to continue working on the Crimson Fleet infiltration missions that I've been assigned by the UC Navy. And we'll, go through the first few steps for that. Let's get to it. Fracking station. Cydonia. Let's go.
If you're here to buy or sell, you might want to talk to Octai. I'm busy.
I'm here to sell, but I'm looking for you.
Wouldn't be the first time I've heard that line. Oh, don't give me that look. I'm just having a laugh. What have you got for me?
Take a look at this sample.
Aurora, huh? Nice. A little too hot to handle, though. What else you got?
The Trade Authority turning away contraband. Now I've seen everything.
If you can't handle it, point me to someone who can.
All I'm going to point at is the ceiling, with my middle finger. Get that stuff out of here before UC security catches on. Of course, if there's a finder's fee you're offering, I might, well, bend the rules a little bit.
Pay 1,000 credits. Does this
You
work?
know, it's funny. Suddenly, I do remember someone who might be able to unload that stuff for you.
Well, it appears she suddenly remembers everything. How nice.
There's a buddy of mine who runs with the Crimson Fleet. Goes by the name Adler Kemp. If he isn't passed out, you can find him killing the rest of his brain cells at the Broken Spear. Oh, and it's been a pleasure doing business with you.
Hey, welcome to the Cydonia Trade Authority.
Seth Rogen?
Unless you're here to serve me another drink, you can turn around and walk away.
Give sample. Shaoshiba Bowden said you could help me move some of this.
Hey, why don't you say that a little louder? I don't think every single UC guard in Cydonia heard you. Okay. Yeah, I think we can help you with this. If you've got a whole shipment of this stuff, you're going to need to move it fast. But you're going to have to do something for us first.
Oh my god, are you kidding? Who's we and us? I thought I was dealing with you.
You're a clever one, aren't you? Let's just say I have a certain influential affiliation. And leave it at that. Basically, you want that Aurora moved? I'm your guy.
Sure, she never said anything about that.
Yeah, well, she isn't running the show here. I am.
Well, this is utterly ridiculous. Do we really have to jump through these hoops to get what we need from you?
Lady, if you want me to move that shipment for your pal here, you're going to do whatever the hell I want. You got that? Now listen up, because I'm not going to repeat myself. I need you to deal with a miner who's racked up a bunch of debt. He probably spent it all on booze, not that I blame him. Either way, I want that money back.
I'll just pay off his debt right now so we can get down to business.
Feel free to throw as many credits in my face as you want, but that isn't the point. We need to make an example out of this guy. His name's Carl Fielding. I think you'll find him wandering around the Deimos miners' quarters. Don't worry, you can't miss him. Just look for the most miserable-looking guy in the entire place.
You must be the guy I'm looking for.
Something I can help you with?
I'm here to collect the credits you owe Adler Kemp.
Adler Kemp? Who the heck is that?
Adler is serious about this debt, so I suggest you pay quickly.
Adler, you said? Nope. I think you have me mixed up with someone else. Look, I'm tired. It's been a long day in the mines. I just want to go home, wash off the dust, and relax. This has been fun, though. Whatever.
I'll go back and tell Adler you said that.
Adler. Oh, wait. You mean that Adler? Yeah, sorry. I thought you were talking about someone else. I told him I'd pay up next week when Deimos cuts our next profit share check. I'll even bring it to him personally. Hmm? Sound good? Yeah?
I don't think Adler is going to be satisfied with that option.
Well, I mean, he doesn't really have a choice. Look, I haven't got a single credit to spare right now, okay? You can't squeeze blood from a stone, you know? Right?
Perhaps he's already been through enough.
Promise to stop borrowing from Adler and I'll pay the debt for you.
Holy crap! Really? You'd do that for me? Wow. I don't even know what to say. Thank you. For everything. And don't worry. I'll never borrow anything from Adler again. I promise.
Tampering with a certified Deimos mining robot is forbidden. I would not recommend it, unless you wish to test my defensive capabilities.
Okay.
Please remain 2 meters away for your safety.
Got an attitude. Robot's got an attitude. Got an attitude. Robot's got an attitude.
Dr. Mead.
Get an attitude, robots get an attitude.
Don't
get
catch yourself attitude. In the loose group when you're pregnant.
Mr. Kemp?
Have something for me?
Yeah, it's all here.
Well, would you look at that. I knew that bum was holding out on me. He going to be a problem anymore? Or did he get the message?
He got the message.
Nice, nice. You're kind of a natural at this. Leaning on deadbeats comes easy to you. I like that. You know, if you like this kind of work, I can get you more. A lot more. You think you can handle running with my, associates?
If you think they can handle me.
That's what I'm talking about. I like your style. All right. I'll call ahead and get a hold of Neva Mora. She's second to the big boss himself. Head out to Europa. You'll find her there.
Ooh,
I suggest
Europa.
You listen to whatever she has to say. Oh, and I've taken care of that Aurora shipment for you, too. Don't spend all that cash in one place.
It's my favorite moon in the solar system. Other than our moon. I like the interesting theory that the inside of Europa is actually liquid because the constant pull of all the other moons and Jupiter kind of kneads the surface of Europa, kind of forcing it to like heat up in the center. So they say like, oh, it could have an ocean and it's the right kind of elements that it could have. You know, life inside the ocean in Europa. Oh, am I not wearing a suit? Why am I not wearing a suit? I forgot. That's why.
can I be of service, Captain?
I don't know. Let's go to Europa.
Pressure holding. Take off lift coat.
Wow, it's so pretty. Okay, to Europa.
Wow! Look who finally had the guts to show up. Looks like Adler finally did something right for once. So, Big Shot, I hear Adler thinks you're good enough to join our crew.
Oh. Adler said that? I didn't know he cared. No.
So, before I put you to work, let's get everything out in the open. I don't know if Adler mentioned it, and for his sake, I hope he hasn't. But you aren't about to sign up with any average pirate crew. You're signing up with the Crimson Fleet. That's if you get through this little task I have planned for you. There's a medical supply ship called the Rigana. Jumping into Enceladus's orbit. On board that ship, you'll find a traitor named Austin Rake. I want him dead.
I think Enceladus is one of the other moons that might have an ocean inside of it. But I'm pretty sure that one's around Saturn, not Jupiter. Consider it done.
It's done when Rake stops breathing. Head back here when you're finished. And don't keep me waiting for long.
Why do you want Austin Rake dead? How can you be certain that Austin Rake is on the Rigana? I guess why.
Rake used to run with the fleet. Hell, I'm the one who vouched for him in the first place. Back then he had a different name and a different identity. He was a damn good earner too. Brought in a ton of creds. Everything was fine until he wanted out. So he ran. And nobody, I mean nobody, runs away from the fleet.
Okay. How can you be certain that Austin Rake is on the Rigana?
I've been tracking Rake for months. He's making it tough, not gonna lie. He changes his location and identity so often, it's costing me a small fortune just to keep tabs. But you know what? It's worth every damn cred. He's made me look like a fool in front of Delgado, and I'm gonna have his head on a pike.
Cool. All right. Yeah, it is the moon of Saturn.
This is Dmitry Moldavsky, pilot of the Rigana. We are a simple transport ship heading to New Homestead. We do not want any trouble.
Then boy, do I have some bad news for you.
I do not understand. Please confirm your intentions.
UC Sysdef, the fleet wants Austin Rake dead. I'd like to board your ship and talk about how to spare him.
Oh god, I do not know.
Keep in mind, we're not threatening to board you. We're asking. The distinction is rather important.
Well, normally I would say no, but frankly it will be safer for us that way. All right, you can dock. We will talk then.
I am not sure what to make of you being here. If you wanted to kill us, you could have done that from your ship. If you wanted our cargo, we could have jettisoned it. I guess I should just stop talking and let you say your piece.
I don't know who's listening over comms. This is safer.
That is true. Which means you don't want somebody to know what you are really up to. Now, do you mind telling us what this is all about?
Eusis is deaf. The fleet wants to rake dead, but I want to resolve this without violence.
You really do not know which one of us is rake, do you? And you do not seem to care either, which makes me think you really want to save him. Okay, I have idea. We can strike his name from Manifest, make it so he was never on board. Then, when we dock, we will leave him on this ship and deliver him to another port.
Deliver him to Sysdef. If the fleet find out about this deal, we're both exposed.
That is fair. We do not want any part of the fleet. Is that all right with you, Austin?
Do I have a choice?
It does not appear you do. Well then, it is agreed. You go back to your ship, and we will make sure Rake was never on ours. And in case any of your handlers get suspicious, here. We had an extra crate of supplies loaded, in case one got damaged. This should be proof you were not here to bargain.
So now what? They're gonna put me in a Sysdef prison? I'm not saying it's worse than death, but it's pretty damn close.
Such a weird sound. It's just gonna stay like this. Oh my god, it's so scary. That's terrifying. Yeah, I guess Austin Rake is dead. The Regana survived. I guess I have to reload. I hope this is gonna fix with the reload. They should have a mode where you could just listen to it like this. Yeah, I totally understood every word you just said. It's about damn time. I feel like I'm having psychic communications with some alien. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe and leave a comment. I'd love to hear from you. I will be doing more of these soon. So be good to yourself, be good to each other, and bye-bye.